right, everybody. Rodrigo Geronimo is warming up right now to play the hot seat match with Francisco Bustamante. We're at the Mez West 8 Tour. Stop number 4 at Plush Pocket in Northridge, California, right on Parthenia and Balboa. Mez West 8 Tour sponsored by Mez Q's and West 8 Billiards. Also by Marty Carey's Jump Q and Virtual Pool 4. And we are also, this match is about to get started. We're also in the middle of a match between Johnny Kang and Santos Sambajon. So let's just catch that match until Rodrigo and Bustamante get started, because Rodrigo and Bustamante are the hot seat match. They've been playing hard for the last couple days. And a 91-player field, four players remain. Santos Sambajon, Johnny Kang, Rodrigo Geronimo, Bustamante. Oh, and Efren Reyes. Yes, so we have five players who remain. The loser of this match you're watching here, Santos versus Johnny, will play Efren Reyes. Busti just arriving, and Rodrigo still warming up. We're going to come back to this match that you're watching right now between Santos and Johnny, between racks, and provide you with score updates. But the hot seat match is next on the main feature table, so let's just wait for that match to get started and enjoy. Johnny Kang has just been playing absolutely. Johnny Kang. Who deserves his own personalized flag designed by Geraldine Thibodeau. She made this logo for Johnny. And what is that logo? How is that? Is that Johnny Kang in Korean, just above the eight ball? All right, and the Korean flag with the eight ball. So there you go, Johnny Kang.
That's right. This is a good match.
Johnny Kang's new logo. Oh! Maybe we should take that logo away from him. He just missed an easy eight ball. And that's not the caliber of play that he was exhibiting when he played Francisco Bustamante going to the hill with Francisco. Santos? Yeah. Santos misses a bank. And says, here, Johnny, I don't want it. We'll get back to that match shortly. So without further ado, let's start this match between Francisco Bustamante and Rodrigo Geronimo for the hot seat. Really glad you guys could join us today on POV Pool at the Mez West 8 Tour. Stop number 4 in Northridge, California. Here we go. Even race to 9, Francisco Django Bustamante, who has fought hard to get here. Almost lost to Johnny Kang in the previous match he played. Sorry about that. Oh! And a great break. Thank you. And this is not an ideal spread here. And Rodrigo's kicking to try to hit the two ball, even if he I was going to say, even if he gives Django ball in hand after that, but you know, even if he misses the two, there's no clear path for the two ball to a pocket other than a bank shot. But Rodrigo plays an outstanding kick safe, threads the needle between the five and the seven. Provides safe cover using the seven ball. Creates distance, yeah. Django is jacked up, jumps with his playing cue, and opens the door. This is Geronimo. Geronimo's been in town now for just over 2 months, I believe. He played the Hard Times 10 ball. I'm sorry, the first Mez West State Tour stop. Missed the Hard Times 10 ball. Hey. And it looks like we have a additional Pinoy crew here. Alex Lowenko of Sticks Billiards and Bruce Castillo in the house. Yeah, yeah. Santos, by the way, was defeated by Johnny Kang. Santos was defeated by Johnny Kang. I don't know what the final score was. 8-4. So Johnny Kang will go on to play Efren Reyes.
Yeah, and Johnny said he's been struggling. He said he felt like he played bad that match.
Okay. All right, Johnny. Be right back.
you folks. It's hard to tell if we can see the whole ball. I'm surprised by that shot. He rushed that a bit. The actual shot. Not the fake out of it.
Wow.
Looks like he missed that too, but that's a big pocket. They're not unfulfilled. Like, they're not super big. They play nice. I like them. If you make a good shot, it's going to go. And well, I haven't had any problems. They're playing really nice. Ooh, Lucy looked like he was a little nervous by that. A little tic-tac-toe to go ahead and get out there. And that'll make it 1-0. Mr. Bustamante. It is the hot seat match. This is a race to 9. Interesting fact, had Santos beat Johnny, it would have been an all-Filipino final.
Big shocker.
As it is, 3 of the final 4 are Filipinos. 2 of the Filipinos are locals? Oh, 2 of the finalists. Yes. Well, Johnny Santos is not in the tournament anymore. Johnny's not. But Rodrigo is actually kind of a transplant. When he's in the States, he stays in Carson. So, somewhat, when he's here, 1-0. But he doesn't stay here full time. He's off and on. Players in this event. No, I don't think they got it. No. It would end up being 91 buildings. So. At one point they said 94, and I knew at least one person didn't show up, and however it went from there. John paid his entry, and that doesn't go back, so he counts. Yeah, that was a little unexpected. This morning we got the text from, or actually the message that John Schmidt wasn't able to make it today due to personal reasons. Nothing bad, he said, he just wasn't able to make it. So that was a bit surprising since he was on the winner's side. Bustamante is not afraid of the new kid on the block, and it's kind of showing him what's what. They're all friends from the Philippines, by the way. They all know each other and have interacted with one another. Rodrigo, Geronimo, Bustamante, and Efren. Commentator's curse strikes again. Well, I think he worried too much about where the cue ball was going to end up. Just make it and let the cue ball do its own work. Thank you. Testing, 1, 2, 3. Testing, 1, 2, 3. And it seems like, oh, there it is. I can see the little, now it seems loud. Testing. Is that too loud? Are we okay? Okay, we're back, ladies and gentlemen. Sorry for that little delay. Thank you for my friends out there in Texland that sent us some messages letting us know that there was a problem. Bustamante's at the table. And he made a nice shot on the one down the rail and is now looking at the two ball. I think he's going to draw it back out for the three. We've created a monster in Omar.
No, this will probably be the last time for this, but it is cool to sit in the best seat in the house and sweat these matches. Well, in San Diego, I'll hopefully be playing. Trying to be like you, Brooke, and text and sweat at the same time.
Yeah, and he can't do that.
Yeah, not a good multitasker, obviously.
I'm watching him. He hasn't watched the game at all. So he's a little close to his work, and he doesn't have a strong angle. I think he's got to play a safety here. Maybe tuck it down behind the seven. Chest set. And put the cue ball up by the nine ball. And how do you like
nice
my
little
style?
Safety. Perfect.
So, Rodrigo's looking at it. Luckily, the guys were not looking up when Daniel inadvertently used his flash. He's got a two-rail kick at this.
One rail. Just
really?
Above
you don't
the
think
sun?
He's going to try and
catch the bottom
rail to spend it? To spin it, I mean?
Yeah. You're right. I'm wrong.
Well, no, I mean, I'm just saying that's what I see. I'm not saying it's all right.
I'd just be happy to hit this ball.
You're like 90% of this ball. Don't be a baby.
One
it's
rail.
A good hit. And, but he... hit that with a lot of spin. It's still spinning. We got a straight in shot into the corner or a back cut into the side. Looks like he's going to be cutting in the side so he can float the cue ball around.
Great shot. Three rows for shape on the, to get on the four.
Now, is this another one you float in the side and pull it over for the seven?
Yeah, just draw it in, draw it, shoot it in the side and draw it over.
When I say pool, that's what I mean. Yeah. It's usually that below center where it kind of takes the tangent line. Stop.
Wow, even we figured that out.
Very nice recovery by Francisco. Made that nice safety off the three when he got poor position. And
that makes it 2-1.
Made a great out. And here we go for the third-fourth match. It's Efren Reyes going to 9 versus Johnny Kang going to 8. Johnny is one of our local top players. We had a conversation earlier today, and I was intrigued to find out that he still does not consider himself to be a professional, and that he thinks of himself as an amateur. And I think that's kind of cool. I mean, it means he has that much still to learn, but I'm not sure what class that puts me in.
Is there a class under amateur that we could be placed into?
League member?
Yeah, I still qualify to play in leagues.
Everybody qualifies to play in leagues. I spoke with Jeremy Jones a few months back, and he was telling me he plays league in Texas. So everybody plays league.
This guy's got a pretty big break, just like Francisco.
Edgy's been Rodrigo's been having a very nice break. His this is actually kind of poor placement with the cue ball for him. He's been getting it more center of the table, but he has a really nice look at it. Be able to just come out one rail up and shoot the two into the, well, never mind.
Two rails.
You have to say it before he does it, or it means nothing.
I know. I was just pointing out what he was actually doing. You looking for a game?
Well, he shot it in the side, which is what I said, so I'm taking partial credit. And they are underway on the second table. Johnny wins the flip.
A beautiful shot there.
Oh, that was nice. Even if he had caught the six a little bit, he still would have ended
perfect,
up real nice.
Yeah.
So now this one, you go two rails into the corner and come out?
I personally would probably go, forward two rails.
Yeah.
Yeah. But of course, he'll probably go punch it back, just like what he's doing. There you go.
The backwards two rails. Rodrigo needs to make his presence felt. He's had a few unforced errors, so we need to see him close out this game.
I think he got a little straighter here than he wanted to. He's going to be close on the rail when he shoots the 9.
He's just going to make it. He'll roll down and or shoot it super hard and get off the rail. Efren seems to be looking for something. So Johnny broke on the second table and came up dry. And a nice out.
Shot.
Break and run by Rodrigo. That's going to make it
2-2.
2-2. And you guys will have to wait till somebody shows me how to update the scores.
Pretty good crowd in the room still, sweating the matches.
A strong Filipino contingent, as usual, when we get the guys into town.
Yeah, here's James from San Diego, placed 9th through 12th. James right there. One of my new local people that I'm getting to meet down in San Diego.
Gotcha. Yeah, we have several players that came up from our area, Carson and Bellflower, that came out to watch. Wow. No love for that monster break.
Now, both these guys have a really big break. Francisco's always been known for having a big break, but...
It's kind of funny seeing Rodrigo. He has such a slight frame.
Yeah. Well, him and Santos. Look at Santos.
Yeah, well, he's not that slight.
Santos?
No, Rodrigo isn't that slight. So he just opted to just lay it down. He put it the two ball on the rail.
But looks like he might have given him a little window.
That little scratch of the head, I'm thinking that...
I think he might have come up in the window there.
Geronimo can see the ball. He could see the whole ball. And...
Looks like he played shape of the combo. Maybe I don't know if that was intentional.
I don't think from his body language that it was intentional. I'm going to take a leap of faith and say it was not intentional. But
not happy shooting a 3-9 combo.
I've been watching. Well, this isn't an easy combo, but I've watched him shoot quite a few that have, he's made some great combos. Earlier today, when he was playing Oscar Dominguez, Oscar made quite a few nice combos as well.
Usually you hear about great things about Oscar's safety play.
He made some stunner combos. It was really cool to watch. He might be playing the 3 to the corner and the 9 to the corner as well. Well, there you go.
Great shot. And that makes it 3-2 for...
3-2 with Rodrigo breaking.
I keep looking at my beer, but it's empty.
We're going to send Omar to go get another beer, I think. He looks sad. Did the 4 get out of the way? It looks like it did from this camera angle. The 7 to the 8 is a little bit interesting. And the 4-6 is a bit tight. He tried to brush that 6 to get it out of the way, and unfortunately, he pushed it into the shot. But it looks like he might have the angle off of this 2 ball to go ahead and come down and open that back up. It may, if he doesn't catch that 6 ball full, though, it may leave him tough on the 3. So that's what I was afraid of with that shot. He shot one of these earlier, and it was not, it didn't end up well for him. So I think he'll take this one just a tad bit slower. Yeah. Because where the six ball is, you don't need to be right on it. He's got plenty of room to make things happen. Nice. Watch out. No, he got okay. Looked like maybe he was going to get a little too straight, and he might still have gotten a bit too straight on this.
Wow.
We were at the Epic Billiards not too long ago, and he was practicing his draw shots, and he was just doing them for fun. But I have to say, it was like that. It was fabulous draw shots. They don't usually come up for the top players. See, that's the shot I like. He didn't worry about the cue ball. You just make the ball and make the ball.
Just floated it over for perfect shape.
Another break and run for Geronimo. He's going to go up 4-2 against Bustamante. Boosty's going to be breaking. And I'm going to predict that he breaks really, really hard because I think he's a little frustrated right now. He missed a safety and now he's down two games instead of being up.
And that, what about these players? You just miss one little shot and it could cost you the whole set.
It can. This alternate breaks keeps everybody.
Gives everybody a shot at the table.
Yeah, you can't dominate, but if your break's not working, it's certainly going to hinder you.
Love his break.
I like his cue ball when he breaks. He just parks that. Bam. Oh, I just looked up to the other table and watched Efren miss a wow.
You were right. He was going to break big.
Got out some of the frustration right there.
Three balls on the break with perfect shape position.
But he let his cue ball loose a little bit. It hit the side rail just below the side pocket, but it ended up real nice. On the other table, I'm not sure the score right yet, but Efren just missed an 8-ball into the side, giving Johnny a long shot on the 8 that he just has to go up and down table to get back on the 9.
And Johnny hit it perfect.
A little bit under. Boosty pulls back. The 6 is a little interesting. He's going to have to come across the table and shoot it into the same pocket.
It doesn't go?
Not past the 7.
You are right.
And he hit that brilliantly. I think he might have liked to be down just a little more. It gives it a straighter shot. It's got quite a bit of angle on this. He might have to come into
the 7. Pick up the 7, yeah. Oh, no. A lot of inside.
That was... Wow.
Pretty sporty. And the 8-ball's frozen on the rail, so... Well, it's just probably a little bit angle.
Slight
angle. Little slight angle.
There it is.
And just a little bit off the rail to be just nice and roll it in.
He's fine where he's at. So... With a pop. There we go.
Perfect.
It's a break and run by Bustamante to put the match at 4-3, Geronimo. Thank you. this is the first match I've seen where it's been a battle of break and runs. Like, I think in the last match, we only saw one break and run.
One break and run in the whole match.
And now we've already seen three, and the score is 4-3, Geronimo over Bustamante.
Both these guys just have such a big break.
What's, they're working. The breaks are working. It's really nice to watch. Wow.
We're gonna squat that rock.
Oh, let's see where the one ends up.
Should
it's
be fine.
Nice shot back on it. It's a six ball on the bottom rail. Now, can he get around that to get to the three?
I think he can. Or if he can't, he'll probably just draw it over. Yeah. Put it.
I like how they move the rack. They barely lift that ball and then pull it out real quick.
Yeah.
I tried to do that once and move the ball about 4 inches. Luckily, my opponent laughed and just put it back.
Can't tell. Looks like he's going to try to come underneath the 6-7.
Try and pull through the window and go two rails?
Yeah.
To the side, bottom rail to the side rail and out.
Or he'll just simply just draw it over, but looks like he's looking at coming underneath.
You're looking at a
forward
stroke, so I'm not sure. There it is, yeah.
And that's not probably what he wanted.
Well, he can see the three.
Still can see the three, though. Should be okay.
He's not going to be happy with his leave, but he can see it. If he can see it, he can make it.
Don't know why he used inside on that. But
I think he thought that by using the inside, he would escape hitting the seven, but it was too much and killed it right into the seven.
Nice shot, nice recovery. Perfect on the four. Nice punch angle back over to the six.
And I heard tale that depending on how early the tournament finishes, that there may be a match between these two at Epic Billiards in Carson if the tournament finishes early enough.
Between Effort and Francisco?
These two would be Geronimo and
Bustamante. Geronimo and Francisco? Yes, I am losing my mind.
So stay tuned to find out about that. But we still have quite a few matches coming up for you here on POV Pool. We're here at Plush Pockets in Northridge.
It's a break and run fest.
I have to say, I'm really enjoying this.
Perfect.
Nice.
The third break and run in
a row. Nice out for Geronimo, and the fourth break and run overall. So,
5-3.
This is just a great match. So here comes Bustamante's break. Wow.
Massive.
Ooh, we got a funny kiss off that too. And he does not have a shot on the one ball. I'm sure he's going to figure out a cool safety here, but he's disappointed that he doesn't get to get that out.
Give me just roll it up, freeze the cue ball on the two.
I don't know. That distance is a little
hard to do a slow roll like that.
Well, the rails are playing a little bouncy, and it's a little hard to judge, I would think.
I
That's way upstairs. He didn't get him. I'm not sure. I can't tell from the angle we're at in the chair if he can actually see it, but he's not froze to the floor. So at the very least, he's got a one rail kick into the one ball.
Yeah, I think he can get underneath it.
He might be able to see a part of it, but he's looking at the kick.
He's looking at the kick. Kick and safe.
And what he's looking at is kicking it, sliding the cue ball behind the nine, and sending the one ball up table, hopefully behind the five, two, and three. He still might get it. No. Bustamante's going to have a whole one ball to shoot at.
Don't know if he's got a pocket, though. I can't tell.
He decided not to risk it. But again, that's... He's... No.
Left him
Geronimo's going to have an entire ball to shoot at and a very makeable ball. The problem is the two ball is not an easy ball to make.
Looks like he's going for the combo. Something you don't see from the pros too often.
I'm telling you what. It's one of the reasons I love nine ball, and I know there's a lot of people that love 10 ball, and I love 10 ball too, but for different reasons. The wonder of nine ball is you do get to slide at that nine ball and take a chance at it sometimes.
Swing at it every once in a while.
Lucky nine ball, take a ride. Ooh. He missed it and left him straight in on the one ball.
But the two's a little tricky. He's got to get underneath it.
He's got an angle. He's got an angle to get underneath it. I think he can go two rails. One, two, and back underneath for the two up in the same pocket that the cue ball's in.
Or for the side pocket. Perfect.
Oh, I thought the five was in the way. It was hard to tell. It's not, but I thought it was.
Yeah.
Ooh, he thought he missed
that
ball.
Used the whole pocket.
The way he slung that cue ball, that cue after he shot that. He's got a little tic-tac-toe action. He's just going to pull this out, shoot the five in the side, come on back for the six, and then back and forth on the eight and nine.
Only concern here is getting himself a good angle on the eight ball. Which should be no problem for Francisco.
I don't know. That's a little steep. Seeing as where the nine ball is.
Probably a little bit more angle than he wanted, but should be okay.
He's gonna shoot it and just pull it off that rail.
That's the pocket he missed earlier.
Yeah, but he hit an entirely different speed when he missed.
Much better confident speed. Oh man.
You know, lining up, you could see he wasn't, he didn't look right on that ball. He went ahead and conceded the game. He moved Geronimo's coin.
So
it's now
6-3,
Geronimo. That was unexpected after making that really nice shot on the eight ball.
Seems like he just kind of rushed it a little bit.
See you next time.
What's up, buddy? Oh, What was the line on this match, do you know?
I didn't hear a line. You know, in this, Geronimo's had some really good showings in this tournament. He's won an event. He took fourth in an event. Nobody here that knows the tour underestimates him. And it goes past that five ball.
Believe it or not, I was actually thinking Francisco might be getting a game or two.
Wow.
From whatever
I'm going to tell him that later.
Whatever he's told me about this guy.
I'm going to tell him that later. We'll see how you like it. No. Geronimo is a consummate player, but Bustamante doesn't take weight from very many people. I'm sure he would take a couple games if he wanted to give it to him, though. I'm pretty sure if the match goes off tonight at Epic that it'll be an even race.
I'm guessing it will be. It's a good preview of what their action's going to look like, though. Break and run, break and run, break and
run. That'd be awesome. We're missing one of our action players, Ruben Bustamante, or Bautista, I'm sorry, isn't at this event. He's been having a couple of good events as well.
Tricky here, going up and down and then trying to get on the eight. But should be no problem. Came up a little short, or actually a lot short on that one.
From here, it doesn't look like he can see the seven.
Yeah, I think he can get an edge of it, but...
Enough to make it?
He does have enough to make it. Whether he goes for it is a whole different thing.
Now, he's got enough behind the seven to do a nice kick. Firm. Holds the cue ball behind the nine. Kicks the seven to the side rail and down to the bottom rail.
Yeah, he's got a couple options here.
It looks like he's... I can't tell.
Yeah, he went for the safety.
Yay. I love it when one of my plans come together.
Hit it perfect. Looks like Francisco's going to probably get out his jump cue here.
I don't think so. I think he'll go two rails.
Two rails.
The reason I don't think the jump cue is I don't see what you're advancing.
Yeah, you can't hold it up. Oh, what? No, he's getting the jump cue out.
I'm sorry, Omar.
Look, I guess
Omar
something
was
right
one time.
Wow, one time, huh?
Maybe twice. I just don't see what you get out of this. You're going to be hitting it so close to the rail. It's easy to lose the cue ball off the table.
Wow, oh, didn't get over the ball.
That was unexpected. So, Geronimo goes to the table with ball in hand. Three balls on the table and a lead of 6-3.
6-3, yeah. A little indecisive on how he wants to play this right now.
I think there's just so many options.
Yeah.
Sometimes it gets a little tough. I'm glad to see it isn't just me.
So, you'll just come around one rail, two rails.
He did a little slip stroke there. It was a little odd. Did you see that when he like made it? He kind of threw his body after
it.
Right? I'm going to ask about that later.
Hit that perfect. Good speed. Francisco conceded. And it's now 7-3.
7-3, and Bustamante will be breaking. This is it's a pretty strong lead going to 9 with alternate break.
Do you know what the score of Efren and Johnny is right now?
I don't, but let's see if we can get some feelers out. If Bustamante gets out of the way, sometimes I can read the coins. I see a 4. And is that a 4 on both sides? We're going to find out for you, so hold tight on that one. We'll find out what the score is on Efren and Johnny.
And they're playing for third, fourth, right?
Well, it's a score of 4-2 on the Efren and Johnny Kang match, and we do not know who's ahead. So after this match finishes, we'll be able to tell you who's leading that match. Johnny's having a very good tournament, though, so either.
Well, for him to be in the top four in this field really
says
something.
He took third at the tournament in Hard Times, Bellflower. He took third behind Mystica and Geronimo.
Efren just missed a pretty basic shot, and then Francisco just missed a pretty basic shot.
And almost got lucky with 7. Well, if that's how Efren's playing, it would be very easy for Johnny to have the lead on that match.
And it looks like Francisco's heart's just not in it anymore.
Well, he's pushing a little hard, I think. Yeah. I think his heart's a little too in it. Johnny might not have the easiest shot over on the other table, by the way. The 9 might be blocking his straight-in shot. And Geronimo comes out. He's got that same shot he shot earlier.
Just going to roll
this
in. Great shot.
And again, Bustamante goes ahead and gives him the 9 ball. Geronimo's going to be breaking to win the hot seat. Its score is now 8-3 with Geronimo breaking.
And it looks like on the other table, it's 4-3, Efren.
4-3, which means that, yeah, Efren's ahead. Except that Johnny moved the side that I thought already had the 4. I see, but I don't see a 4 over on Efren's side.
Efren has 2. It's 3-2, Johnny.
Yeah, we misheard earlier, and it's 3-2. Johnny King's up on Efren, and again, Johnny goes to 8, folks. So
it's a pretty good break here.
The 2's interesting.
2's a little tough. See what he does.
Now
make it and then play safe on the 2.
How do you get what he shoots the 1 and pulls it back?
Yeah.
The 2 might not be as tough as we think. We have kind of a funny angle.
He might actually have a shot on the 2 if he pulls it out enough.
We've got Johnny over on the other table. And
I think he can make it.
Okay, so Johnny tried to shoot a safety, came up a little short on it. And now we're back to Geronimo.
Oh, Geronimo.
He got really good on the 2 ball. And
tried
I think
to
he was a little
in.
Nervous because of how close it was to that 3 and missed it.
I think he tried to throw it in and just didn't get enough throw on it.
Yeah. I don't know about that shot. He wanted to keep the angle so he could take the natural angle to get to the 4, but this is really on the rail. A little short, but it gives him the natural angle for the 6 if he just shoots it in.
To the bottom rail and punch it out. Like that.
Easy peasy. Now, stop ball?
No, just float it up like that.
Wow, that's way more than
a little bit far.
And he's kind of on the wrong side.
Now he's going to draw 2 rails.
He's kind of letting his stroke out and trying to get comfortable with the table.
It looks like he's getting his...
Geronimo goes ahead and gives it back to Bustamante. That makes it 8-4, and Bustamante's breaking. So that two ball is going to... Well, it could cost Geronimo two games.
Well, with Boosty's break.
Yeah, that's why.
Yeah. Anytime you let him to the table, with this format, it could possibly cost you two games. These guys break just so well.
Well, let's see where that one ends up.
He's
going
to have
a shot.
Looks like
he's
going to have a shot, yeah.
The six to the seven.
Should be no problem.
To the eight.
No problem. None whatsoever.
You're very confident.
None whatsoever. Six goes right past the eight. Stop shot, draw back.
Wow.
Oh, my. Never thought he'd miss that.
He might have gotten lucky, and I think he hooked Geronimo. He just missed and hooked him.
These guys get the good rolls.
Sometimes
I can't complain. I've had my fair share of good rolls.
The match over on Johnny and Efren is 3-3 at this point. But Johnny's going to 8. Efren is going to 9. So, okay. So Geronimo's going to masse.
Wow.
Great shot.
Wow. And that should be the match.
Really, really nice.
Yeah, that was a great shot there.
Commentator curse, Omar.
Oh, yeah, the commentator curse. Yeah, it looks like tic-tac-toe from here.
Yeah, everything's a natural angle as long as he doesn't overshoot anything.
Oh.
He's not chancing anything. I think he's going to...
50-50 here.
I'm 74-30, so I think he might be more than 50-50, sir. And like you said, he got
just
good.
Right.
Just pull it out just a little. He's going to move the rack to make sure it's not in play.
Just punch this up. Punch this out a little bit and then draw the seven ball back for the eight. Should be fine.
Geronimo has a full house tonight of his compatriots from his local pool room epic. There's a whole mess of the guys here.
And
Bustamante gives it to him.
Conceded that to him. It was a great match.
Rodrigo Geronimo in the hot seat of the fourth stop of the Mez Tour. And what we're hearing Desiree, the tournament director, say is that as soon as the match is over with Efren and Johnny King, Bustamante will be back up on the TV table. Aw, what a great smile from Rodrigo right there. Bustamante will be back up on the TV table against the winner of Efren and Johnny King.
They're tied at 3 right now with Efren shooting.
And Efren going to 9.
Efren going to 9. I don't know if you can see it. Huh?